Hey, welcome to my channel. I'm Natalia, and here I talk a lot about the methodology of achieving native-like fluency. I'm not a native speaker myself. If you're not a native speaker either, but you are looking for ways to continuously improve your language skills, I hope you're gonna find this video useful, and let's get started. Today I'm inviting you to talk about writing. I believe that writing is one of the most fundamental skills for any language learner, and when we talk about fluency, we have to include writing fluency as a sub-skill here. So fluency doesn't only mean you speak faster, fluency doesn't only mean you speak with a lot of confidence, because trust me, it's so easy to imitate and to fake confidence. It's a lot harder, speaking confidence I mean, and speaking fluency, it's a lot harder to fake listening fluency and good listening skills. It's a lot easier to learn a few word combinations by heart, to improve your pronunciation, to work on enhancing your accent, and then come across as a very confident person who can use only a set of phrases correctly and in a very confident manner. However, there's no guarantee the same person can hold a conversation, can be in front of a camera, can give an interview in spontaneous situations. To me, fluency means reading fluency, writing fluency, speaking fluency, and listening fluency. What do we do to improve our writing skills? Let's talk about this today. I have a writing course for non-native speakers. It's interesting and fascinating for myself in the first place. How do I develop my writing voice in the English language? What we do in the course is, as non-native speakers, we look at our thought process in writing. That's the entire purpose of the course, to teach people to look at how they think in the English language. When their thought process is in English, what is it even like? Because, you know, we all speak beautiful English in our head. However, when we start talking to other people, sometimes we lose confidence. When we write emails in a foreign language, we might feel like we know exactly what we need to say and how to put it in words, but once we've finished writing that email or that article, that blog post that we want to publish, we look at it and we're full of doubt and we don't even know if that actually makes sense. What I think is essential to do is to look at precisely what is wrong. It's not enough to say, oh, my writing sucks, I wrote something that doesn't make sense, I completely do not like it, I think it's just a bad piece of writing. You know what, it's supposed to be bad. Your first draft is supposed to be long, messy, and ugly, because you're going to edit it later. And that's when it will become beautiful. But many people fall into this trap of criticizing their writing skills and their thinking skills without being precise. What does it even mean that my writing skills are bad or poor and not well developed? What exactly in this piece of writing needs more work? Maybe you need to think about the flow. Maybe you need to connect your ideas better. Maybe there are grammatical errors. Maybe you forgot to use your prepositions, or you forgot to use your articles. Not many native speakers, even those who are very advanced, according to some test certificates that they have, feel the articles and why and where we need to use them. The word combinations that the text is made of don't really make sense, don't really communicate the gist, the message. A lot of non-native speakers want to use sophisticated, beautiful vocabulary because usually in their first language, they're very articulate speakers and they can express a variety of different ideas using metaphors, similes, you know, words and their figurative sense. They can compare things, they can be a little bit poetic, they can show how intelligent and educated they are, and they like it, and they also like talking to other educated people. But as soon as they start speaking in English, they feel like they have to go at least one level down and they have to communicate using the simplest terms. They cannot compare things, they cannot use metaphors, they cannot even build a beautiful sentence. And you know, this is one of the reasons why so many non-native speakers lose confidence in themselves, don't trust their own ability to continue improving their skills. And they look at their writing and they go like, oh, it's just bad. I don't really know what, you know, what is bad about it, but I just don't like it. And that's it. And that's it. And they stop working on the text. But this is a normal process. This is what it should look like. You write a messy draft first. You take a look at it and ask yourself, okay, what did I even want to say? You look at your thought process in writing, you correct your thought process, you edit it, you fix all the things that need to be fixed. If you see that a preposition is missing, you add it. If you see that you use the wrong article, you simply insert the right article. If you see that the word combinations don't make sense, and just to continue developing my idea, what I wanted to say is that a lot of non-native speakers focus on learning advanced vocabulary, and they focus on memorizing set phrases, idioms, collocations, because they want to sound just like they sound in their first language, thoughtful, articulate, eloquent. But what happens is sometimes people just glue these word combinations to one another and they think this is how they build a sentence. They think that if they insert more beautiful collocations that they read somewhere in fiction books and add them on top of one another, they're gonna build a beautiful, sophisticated, smart sentence. In 99% of the cases, this doesn't work, and it reads like a bunch of words and word combinations that are not related to one another. And instead of producing a coherent text, instead of developing your idea and unfolding your message in writing, you give people a job to actually understand how these ideas connect to one another and what do these words have to do in your sentence. Don't do that. The first, I would say the primary skill when you develop your writing skills as a non-native speaker is to learn to look at your thought process in writing, because it's painful and it's not what people enjoy doing. When they start this exercise, and it has to be not just an exercise that you do once, it has to be consistent work. It has to be some sort of routine. So, because you can only see your own results over time. When you teach yourself to look at your thought process in writing and not get upset, but instead use this material to improve your ability to communicate meaning in the English language, this is when you start learning. This is when you start improving a big deal. So write it down, take an honest look at your thought process in the English language, ask yourself, why did I even use these words? Mark all the things that need to be corrected very precisely. Correct prepositions, articles, word combinations, flow, structure, connectors. Edit everything that you see. And what I mean to say is that we only see these things when we actually can see them with our own eyes, when we see them written down. Because as you're developing this text in your head, you don't see that. We never usually record ourselves when we talk. Very few people are actually aware of the way they communicate. We don't listen to ourselves when we communicate with people, when we talk to our family members every day. We don't even pay attention anymore. And I guarantee that if you record your conversations that you have at home every day, just simply carry a phone with you everywhere and have your voice recorder record your conversations. Simply carry a phone around and forget about the fact that you're carrying your phone around or that your voice recorder is on. You are going to be amazed and surprised, and you're gonna learn a lot about yourself by the end of the day when you start playing all these conversations back to yourself. It's not only about what we say, it's a lot about how we say it, our voice, our intonations, our intentions. Do we even finish our thoughts, or do we drop our sentences halfway? Do we connect words? Do we connect ideas? Or do we think that they're so obvious that people are just supposed to know what we mean? When you have already developed that skill, it's a huge improvement when you can take an honest look at what you have written down and you can see how different it is from what you thought you were thinking, from what you thought you said. When you look at it, you realize that it's no wonder that people don't understand you, probably, or that you can't always articulate your thoughts when you speak at the pace at which you want to articulate them. You feel that you need more time, but because you don't have this time, you end up saying what you know and you end up saying what you always know. So you're maintaining and nurturing the same patterns that you probably want to get rid of. Writing is the best exercise to get rid of the old patterns because now you're aware of them. And if they're really consistent old patterns, you're going to see them again and again and you can just weed them out. It's important to always read your final version out loud. At the end of this exercise, when you have come up with a version of your text that you like, you have edited it, you have corrected all the things that had to be corrected, you made sure that now you communicated what you wanted to communicate. It's very important to read it out loud with a lot of confidence, to read it like you own it, to read it in a way that you would say it to someone. I'm not really talking about academic writing skills in this video. I'm not talking about the skill of writing scientific articles, and I'm not talking about writing for money. Well, copywriting is a good skill if you have your own business. I write everything for my own business myself in English, but I'm not talking about that right now. I'm talking about writing as an instrument to self-correct your thinking patterns in the English language and to teach yourself to actually be aware of how you think in English, because that's the skill that we want to develop. We want to learn to think in a foreign language. If we talk about native-like fluency, yes, I mentioned four types of fluency, but the fifth skill that is very important is thinking in English. And I'm not sure if thinking fluency even is a term, but that is what I pay attention to a lot, because as soon as I switch to Russian, which is my first language, I sound like a completely different person. I open my mouth differently, I produce different sounds. I also speak quite fast in my first language, but I sound completely different. And when people hear me on the phone, when I speak Russian, they often ask me, did I dial the right number? Is that the same person? Because I do sound different. And I know it's a normal thing. It's very normal because I think different too. As soon as I switch to English, I start thinking differently. I create different images. I can capture different images that simply do not exist in the Russian language, and they don't exist in the mentality of anybody who speaks Russian from birth. We just see the world differently. We watched different cartoons when we were kids, we had different superheroes, we read different books, and we just see the world differently. That is normal, but when we develop native-like fluency, we learn to absorb the cultural context as well. Not just the words, not just the grammar, but the culture, so that we can communicate the meaning to other people. And again, I'm coming back to writing, because writing is one of the most amazing exercises to teach yourself to self-correct your thinking patterns. Most probably, you will find out that you're not thinking in English, but you're simply translating the thought process that is happening in your first language. And you're translating it, and you're putting it on paper. And if you see that that is what's happening, you should not be blaming yourself for that. Instead, you should be using it as an opportunity to correct that. In order to correct that, we need to see a lot of good examples. And all my students, everybody who's taken the writing courses, I have two of them, they know that editing their own text doesn't mean editing them according to what they believe is correct in the English language or what they know. We only speak this way because this is what we know. We have our own limited toolbox that we dig into it when we need to say something in English, but it's very limited. And if we only use what we know, we're never going to grow. Our skills are never going to change. We always need to step outside of what we know in order to learn to communicate our ideas better and in order to learn to sound more natural and more fluent. So when my students added their text, they're learning to learn from native speakers. Okay, this is how I put my ideas into words. What would a native speaker say? How do I find this information? Where do I go? Where do I start looking? And how do I know that I have completed my search and that I have found the right word combination? These are the questions that they know how to answer, and they all come up, you know, when they and all of them, when they compare the original version and the final edited version, it's day and night. one sounds like a direct translation most of the time, and the final version always sounds like it's a text that a native speaker would understand immediately. The first text would give a native speaker a job to put these ideas together, to connect them and to make sense of them. The second text flows like music and it's very easy to follow. And this is what we're learning to do in the writing course. I wanted to make this video for students who already know how to self-correct their thinking patterns in writing, who have already learned that skill. It doesn't mean they never have to do this again. It only means that they do this now on autopilot. They do it all the time because they can. They have learned to do that. But what do you do next? What is it that you do next to continuously improve your writing skills? That's the question that I've been asking myself. And I know that there are a lot of people out there who also need better fluency and who also want to invest in developing their writing skills, because it's not just an exercise to write better. It's not really about that. It's also one of the best exercises that actually gives you clarity, that helps you focus, that helps you find the answers to the questions that are popping up, that are popping inside your head, and maybe one of the best exercises to achieve mental clarity. How do you do it in a foreign language without struggling to think about every word, to translate words, to add it to your thought process? Because you already know that. You don't have to struggle. You know exactly what to do, so you just go ahead and do that. But what do you do next? This is a good question, and I'm going to answer this question in the next video, in the second part of this video. I felt like I needed to give you some background, and maybe that video was helpful for more, and maybe this video was more helpful for people who are just starting out, who have never invested enough time into developing a writing routine in the English language. But the next video is going to be for those people who are truly advanced and who already have speaking and writing fluency in English.